as Sonny the Cool.
His outfit, the Dutch flag.
Yep.
Perfect.
Perfect combination. That's one of the first thoughts. He wasn't good.
Turn number 85 to turn
yellow curve back here at last.
Although mine sounds like that cold. Yeah, once it's warm, it's
a nice Cuba Baker. Yeah, that's probably that one that's got that diesel little Zuzu motor there. So. That's right, it went right up about 100.
Car number 8282, LA turnout.
Turnout. Motor's warmed up.
Ha ha ha.
in the ass, and everywhere else.
Is there any way that you can, like, you know, modify somehow?
I can cut them out here, and they'll fit about that far. That would be it. But they don't look at race like that, right?
Ah.
Not sure what happened.
Oh, let's go. Look out. Look out.
All right.
He already warned you about that.
Yeah.
What?
In no, that,
some kind of slant four?
I don't know what it is.
We have cones here for a reason. You stay near the cones.
Oh, that's one of them. Those things. You don't watch me go down the track, so you have to film me going down the track.
Yeah, I know. I got to run off to you.
Truck while you're driving.
Yeah.
What the fuck do you want?
All right.
Jumping off the park today.
flooded, don't get more.
What does he use it for fueling it? Kerosene?
It's about what it smells like.
It's like kerosene. Can't race if we don't hit her.
Car 153 just earned a speed of 159.348. 159.348 for car 153.
Jeff Stewart doing the honors on car 3082. on a 145.
Congratulations.
In the back? Good luck, man. Good luck.
Yeah. Suspension, you dumb shit.
Seriously?
Fucking A.
Fuck.
All right, choice two, starting round two, motorcycle 2111.
Yep, you are. All right, bring it over here so I can look at it. All right, we see oil on the peg. Fuel tank, primary, and this is all wet. So I know the piston's gone, at least partially. I knew that going down the track though. And my foot's still pretty dry, so that's good. So I know we lost the piston, ain't got time to change. You only got about 20 minutes before we're done with second round. So we're probably not gonna do any more runs this weekend. Now these dumbasses over here are trying to get me suspended. You're
totally,
the driver.
Totally fucked it up.
I went over and talked to the president over there. He said I'm okay, but I told him I got on your asses anyway about it. Now the rule is, you see those cones right there? That's a boundary line. I think there's a wall there about 100 feet tall. You can't go past that line. I can't go past that line. This truck can't go past this line, and my crew can't go past that line. Now you're driving that truck over there. You can stay over there all day long. You're not supposed to come on this side of the line. Now, the penalty for going outside bounds is they take away all my points for the whole meet, and they bust me back to rookie probably and start over and all this kind of crap. So. And also, you got to stay under 15 mile an hour on this side. You got 25 on that side. So, we all got that figured out over here now?
Yes, sir.
Really noted.
Now, you read those rules.
Yeah, I read them.
But you didn't follow them at all. You were co-driving. You're half at fault. You're okay because you're outside the bounds. It's only you and BLM I have to worry about. That's not me. So we only took, about 4 hours to get through impound?
4 hours to get through impound.
Dumbasses. I finally got the head of the overall inspectors. He's a car guy. He's in charge of all race vehicles. And he didn't give a squat about my nitrous bottle not being protected by something stronger than this fucking fairing right here. For some reason, this isn't strong enough for the bike guys. But the car guy didn't give a crap about the bottle. He would just assume have the bottle fall off the bike so it doesn't get tangled up with me or anybody else, which makes perfect sense. But see, the bike guys don't have any common sense, especially if it's run by a stupid-ass lawyer. So there you go. My two cents. So everybody's a dumbass except me, but I blew up the motor, so I'm a dumbass too. So there you go. Evidently, we do not have enough main jet in this carburetor for 50-something percent nitrogen. So next time, we're going to put the big main jet in it. And we're going to put bigger jets in the on the fuel side also. Now, when I hit the second stage, it didn't like taking that 10-degree lead out at all. It just quit running. So it might want a little bit more ignition lead put in it. So maybe we'll bump the ignition lead up a little bit too, just for the hell of it. We don't care what the dyno said. But anyway, that's what a blown up motor looks like when it's all inside the bike. It still is running though, so it's not really blown up. It's just probably a little collapsed and on the rings and a few issues like that. This side of the bike stays pretty clean usually, so we're good to go. So now we get to go back to the pits and party. Or work on the bike. I think we'll get the time slip, see how fast I didn't go. I went through in third gear, but third gear is like what fourth gear used to be, so.
Yeah, they said 115.
Oh, 115. Oh, that puts me right in the middle of 112 and 125.
Perfect.
That's a good run. It's not the worst run of the year, but close. But no, we learned some stuff. We learned about the jetting. We learned about the little more ignition lead, so.
We learned about the cones go.
And you guys learned what the cones meant.
Okay, we did.
So you learn now?
Sorry?
You learned?
Yeah, a little
bit. Everybody learned. Oh, there's another car over there. We're at the finish line down here now, so. All right, so that's it for now. We're going to go play. Yeah, let's go see if there's anything interesting to look at.
What was that?
Anything interesting to look at.
I know.
You watching me?
Yeah, watching you, watching me.
Built. Soda pop. We got a good 20 mile an hour side wind. See how long it keeps running. I told him it was fine down there, the president. So. See if he'll listen to me at all. Guess you know better. Yeah, where's Dave's knuckle? Like the knucklehead in the back of his truck. That's a new type of knucklehead. I like your knucklehead, looks nice.
Hey, you made it, huh?
Look at it.
I'm running out of room to get the night.
the timing slip going.
Speed?
150, 81.
115.81. Third gear.
Not bad.
It was about 6,000, I think, in thirds, all the polar. Third.
So if it'll make fourth, then what would that come out
to? Well, the motor was pretty well done. Pistol wasn't happy at half track, I don't think. It wasn't getting any better at the end of the track either.
No.
But it was running. It pulled up six, but it was down there about 4,500. Actually, I got it back in the third. Anyway. I had to get out the nitrous and shift in the high, and it lost the extra fuel I was putting into it. So I was running full lean again and misfire. Got back on it. It probably came back up and started to pull hard pretty good. But right out of Augusta, finish line almost there anyway. That ride's strong off the line though. That's the strongest run off the line.
Yeah. Yeah, it really lit. It
took off.
Got up close. Did it spin a tire a little bit low? I didn't feel it. Put a lot of dust behind like a tire spin or did...
Yeah, there's a little bit of wheel spin.
There was dust.
But of course the track conditions are real nice too.
Well, it's good traction. Track's really nice. This is bitching. Great dirt.
It's like hardwood floor.
Kind of glazy. Not breaking up.
Well, yeah. We've got a little bit of moisture.
There's almost no dust.
Foam in your foam.
Yeah, 10 mile an hour
wind.
Well, we got 20 mile an hour wind going right now. All right. The side wind. End of the second round right here. There's not too many people left, as you can see, that want to race anymore, including us. So you think I can rebuild the top end in this amount of time?
Want has nothing to do with it.
Well, I could do it if I wanted to.
If there's anyone that could, it would be you.
I could, but the jetty is still too damn lean. I have to change the jetty and all that. That put me over time a little bit. If they even keep running through the whole round. Yeah, fix it on the third pass. You only fix it twice. First round and second round, you can fix. I mean, first round, you can rebuild it. The second round, you don't usually have time to rebuild it after second to do it for third. So if you make a third run, it's on the junk motor for second. So if there's any piston left in it, you make another run. Now, I can make another run right now. Get it run. If I had nitrous. Now, with nitro, I don't know. The nitrous, just hit the button, it'll go. It'll go until there's no piston, and then it don't run. Yeah, see if it wants to help that hard.
Well, then your piston becomes your extra exhaust.
It goes out the exhaust,
So you're ejecting mass behind you, so it's like a rocket at that point.
Yes.
Right.
I don't know anything about it.
There's just enough breeze to keep the dust down.
I just saw two cracks.
Yeah, the dirt out here is really freezing, isn't it?
That's like alligator skin.
It's hard.
What's it called?
F, I think, is the Jimmy class. We got Jimmy 6 in there. Look through this thing to see what's under the hood.
Yeah.
Is it made in Indiana or somewhere? I don't know.
Indianapolis?
No.
It's a Coca-Cola motor.
They don't even make those anymore. That's the H motor there.
Got the real car behind me.
Oh, you're the racer.
Haley!
they go back to the pit.
They went to France with the load.
Not with the load, okay.
Go back.
It's on. Lunch break. Munchies.
We don't eat until it's time to go home. Alright, there's tracks over there. We're gonna go look at it. The starter said it held up really good.
Let's go see how good it is.
Wind's still blowing.
Mm-hmm.
They were close by. So over there is our other meats. So this is this meat.
Okay.
So they took off one set of cones already. So you see all the big holes over there from last meat. This one's barely got anything in it. All the loose dirt on top is where they've been chewing it up a little bit.
Yeah.
This is a lot worse than when I did my run. They got three runs up here today.
Yeah.
So I guess I could have probably fixed my piece of crap.
Yeah.
If I knew they were going to run this long. So you see how torn up it is. Ruts and stuff. Yeah, the steering wheel was jerking back and forth. Yeah, it wasn't like this when I made my run. This is normally what I run through, though, end of the round. So if you get off the track and you go over here where it's smoother, over here, see, the motorcycles are not stupid. We run over here.
Yeah.
Either this side or the other side. Usually this side is smoother than the other side. The car guys, they go over there for some reason. Probably because they can see that side of the truck better. Bike, we can see both sides just fine. So you can see how much smoother it is over here.
Yeah.
You also see the middle of the track is pretty torn up, but this is not too bad. But you can see those guys rusted his tires all the way down. I had two tracks going like this, I had to clear through, steer through, that was back there, so
yeah.
I didn't even see them. So this is where you hammer it down hard, because that's the finish line. The bike crashed up here, up ahead here somewhere.
Okay.
Just past the finish line, the plastic front fender locked up the front tire when you hit the brake.
Okay.
Tore it up. Any big holes in the road, so evidently it was a Harley too, so the guy broke his leg. Yeah, I don't see where he crashed yet, but it looked that bad to me down here.
It's minor frictions going at this speed.
Pretty smooth for me.
Yeah, broken leg on me.
I didn't break a leg when I fell off.
Yeah, it's a minor fraction going at this speed.
You gotta learn how to fall off. He wasn't going as fast as I was. I'd come off at somewhere between 120 and 150. So. See, they're picking up the cores, the cones. So.
Yeah.
So now we're in no man territory. Floating island out here, so you have to go around. I'm not seeing it yet. There's one
fact, they dug up Floating Mound. It's not here anymore. It used to be all through here in the middle someplace. Looks like they cut it out. Oh, here we come. See, we've got big holes around. We got snare around. Gonna go through the spawn. There's Floating Mountain, what's left of it.
Yeah.
Maybe you've got to hammer down through that crap. Get over here and get going. Driving too damn slow, that's the problem.
Yep.
This access road is usually rougher than the one you just did. Start steering around the bad areas. See, down here, the bad area is just everywhere. So you can't see it, it's a little bit. See, that's why you tie the bike in, see?
Yeah.
That might be a reason. This is what it looks like, what's a little bit rougher than we came in at, but a lot slower than we came in at. So this is where you ride your dirt bike up here.
Yeah.
This is all dirt bike riding area. Off-road vehicle park. Anyway, so when we go to El Mirage and Clay, you can do it. Rock in the road, should I hit it? Is the bike still back there?
Yeah.
It appears like it hasn't flown out the back of the bike.
It's tied down good. It's
adequately tied down? Okay.
Yeah.
That pickup truck just caught up to me that fast. All right, that's it for the races. We're done for now.